Hello, this is Chris Fernandez, the founder and CEO of Bikwitus, and I wanted to welcome you to the Bikwitus Website and SEO Breakdown, a special series that analyzes and audits one website's internet presence and SEO strategy in order to provide powerful takeaways for your website. In other words, you're going to get an exclusive, over-the-shoulder look at critical mistakes other companies are making and my recommendations for fixing them in a live video format. My goal is to be honest in my assessments and provide that particular company with a concrete action plan to fix what's wrong for their benefit and, by extension, your company's website as well. This series is going to analyze each website for four major characteristics. First, I'm going to look at first impressions, the overall analysis of the website's look, feel, their targeting, trust factors, social proof, ease of use, professionalism, conversion factors, and call to action. Then, I'm going to look at second impressions. I'm going to look at an overall analysis of a website's social media presence, their blog, and any Web 2.0 interaction that they have on their website. Then, I'm going to roll up my sleeves and look at SEO. We're going to start with top-level SEO, looking at the overall website's keywords, navigation, their rankings, competition, backlink profile, content, and other factors. Then, we're going to dig one step deeper and look at page-level SEO for the structure, tags, usability of on-page ranking factors. After all said and done, I'm going to give you a three-step action plan for the biggest and fastest improvement for this company's website and SEO strategy that you can then also use for your website. So let's get right into it. So today, we're analyzing ProLiability.com. This is a professional liability insurance company, a subsidiary of Marsh, and they have this website that caters to professional liability insurance, malpractice insurance for different audiences and target audiences in terms of the professionals that they're looking to target, from anything from dentists to pharmacists, real estate agents, et cetera, et cetera. And they also do errors and omissions insurance for real estate professionals and other agents as well. So they want to be the number one provider of liability insurance in their target market. So they asked me to analyze their website and agreed to have it for this series. So I'm going to take a look first at my first impressions. What do I think when I come to this website? Let's look at trust factors, the navigation, and what the website itself looks like, what it's doing right and what it's doing wrong. So the first thing I notice when I get to the website is that it looks a bit cheesy. Now, this is nothing personal against ProLiability, but when I come here, it has cheesy stock photography. It's got no personal warmth to it. I don't feel a connection to this website. It feels cold, stale, and more than anything, it feels like a landing page. I know it's a main website domain, but it feels like a professional landing page. So to me, this feels like something that was just put here to rank highly in the search engines. Now, I am biased, right? I'm a search engine optimization expert, an internet marketing expert. So to me, this is what I see when I see it. Maybe other folks, when they land here, they don't think that, but there's something not right about the site. When people come here and they look at it, it doesn't give them that warm feeling of trust, of authority, of being a real site that has great content, that cares about them, that's going to help them find the right insurance for them. It just has overly optimized sections. Look at, they even bolded professional liability insurance. And I will warn that Google is going to start penalizing for over-optimized pages and sites. And this is a prime example of an over-optimized website and page. So that's the first thing, warmth, and it needs to cater more towards being personable. So now I wanted to take a look at the actual navigation and ease of use of the site. So the site doesn't give me any warm, fuzzy feeling, and I know that it's kind of cold. Great, so now can I find what I need? Well, when I go to the drop-down menus, boy, is that is absolutely daunting. There's a lot of stuff here. Now, I understand that you guys want to rank for this. Sites usually want to rank for all kinds of categories and get that SEO value. So if I click, for instance, on athletic trainers, there's also a page level that if we look at, this is athletic trainers, this should be catered towards personal trainers, not athletic trainers. Now, I understand that they have a deal with NATA and ATA, which is an association of the National Athletic Trainers Association. So I understand that that's the nomenclature that they use, is athletic trainers. But most personal training certification bodies use personal trainer. So if I was online, I would never search for athletic trainers insurance. I would search for personal trainers insurance. So that's that kind of thing. ProLiability should look at their nomenclature for their categories. Are you using the right words that you're going to attract for these pages, so you're doing your title tags and all the on-page stuff as well? Again, when I come to this page, has some generic picture here, athletic trainers, it's overly optimized. Where's the value of this page? Why should I link to you? If I'm another site, or let's say I'm an athletic trainer and I'm on Google or Google Plus or Facebook, why should I recommend this page to my friends? Why? Give me a compelling reason to do so. Make it so that when I come to this site, I feel welcomed. I feel like this is a valuable site that's helping me find what I want. In other words, what does ProLiability stand for? If I go back to your homepage, what's your unique selling proposition? What makes you different than all the other insurance companies out there? I'm sure you have some. Let's hear them. Let's see that front and center. Let's make this more warm and inviting. Next is content. There is no content. Now, I spoke with the folks at ProLiability, and they say that it's something that they want to work on is adding a blog, adding some content. So I would say get on that immediately because there's nothing here where I can subscribe. There's a little bit of social media stuff down here, but that's just to share stuff. Where's your newsletter? Where's your, you know, something to keep in touch with me? Give me some way to keep in touch with folks before I leave. And finally, there's this My Account thing at the top here. Either make that bigger or get rid of it entirely, because when I click on that, it brings up this page here where I can log into my account. This right here is very difficult to understand and read. I don't have a username. Do I register? Oh, there's the register. Now, there's some issues with the IT department, the marketing department, all needed to be on the same page, and there's buy-in that needs to take place. ProLiability is a very large company, and Marsh is a very large company, and so there's a lot of buy-in that needs to happen from the top level down. But things as simple as the copyright being 2008, customer service number being way at the bottom, having this old Powered by Velocity logo. These are all trust factors that make me kind of doubt that this site is legitimate. And it's stuff that you need to work on in addition to just being difficult to use and not user-friendly at all. I wanted to do a one-to-one comparison between ProLiability and eHealth.com, which helps people find health insurance, to show that you can do this on a large scale and be more warm and inviting and have a much better site that also caters to what you're trying to do. So if you look at eHealth, they do all the things right that you're supposed to do. The navigation is much simpler and cleaner. Look at that. It's much more inviting. You have pictures of real folks. It's not as generic. You've got new stuff with the video, all kinds of goodies here that should be used as an example to ProLiability of what can be done. And eHealth is a public company, and they also make great content. So I know that ProLiability had a problem with their content and creating boring, they call it boring content. The rule of thumb is content is never boring for the target audience that you're trying to attract. So if we're talking about website design, SEO, look what we're doing right now. That's not boring to you guys out there. So boring content is in the eye of the beholder. There's no such thing as boring content. If you're worried about that, pick topics like eHealth Insurance does, where they add commentary on what's going on in the world today for health insurance, like the Obamacare stuff that's going through the Supreme Court right now, all those kind of things. eHealth makes comments on that. They release press releases and content based on current events and things like that to make their content viral so people share it that care about those issues. I think ProLiability can do a lot of that same kind of stuff to increase their content. So now let's look at Second Impressions. Second Impressions is a website, social media, Web 2.0 presence, and blog. The good news is, that's not going to take very long because ProLiability has no social media presence, no blog, and no Web 2.0 interaction. So I don't even need to spend time on this because, you know, as a company in today's world, you're dead in the water if you do not have social media or Web 2.0 sharing in some way and fashion. So that's something that ProLiability needs to get immediately as part of their overall refresh and site design enhancements. That's what they need to do, and they need to jump on that immediately. So now let's move on to the SEO side of things. So the good news about doing these kind of analysis is that each site and every single company is different in what they're trying to achieve, different in their web presence, different in their SEO profile, and different in my advice to what you need to do to fix things. So for pro liability, let's first take a look at their overall metrics in terms of their trust and page rank and those kind of things, which I like to start with to do a top-down view of everything. So using SEO Moz, I did a quick rank check of the three keywords that Pro Liability wanted to rank for, with professional liability insurance probably being the number one keyword that they want to rank for. So if we take a quick look about where they're ranking there, they're doing very well so far in a number three position for professional liability insurance. So that's very good because that's their number one keyword that they want to rank for. For liability insurance, they're not showing up at all in the top 10. And then for malpractice insurance, they're showing up just now on the first page at number 10. So the recommendation I would give there is, hey, do you really want to go after malpractice insurance, or do you just want to go after your top two, which is professional liability insurance and liability insurance and some offshoot keywords of those as well, and get rid of this malpractice or make a different website for malpractice because it's kind of diverting some of the keyword juice. So I then wanted to look at Pro Liability's backlink discovery, and this is basically how many sites are linking back to proliability.com. This is a big determining factor in where you rank in the search engines. In fact, it's the biggest determining factor in how you rank in the search engines. And this is a view over the last 5 years. And you can see that ProLiability has had a steady increase, or actually it's been pretty steady in terms of their backlink discovery. In other words, not much. This is a monthly view. So monthly, this is what they've been getting. You can see that in the last 6 to 8 months, they went absolutely nuts in terms of getting backlinks and discovery and referring domains. So let's take a look at that now on a cumulative view, and you'll see over the last 5 years how they've grown. So you can see here the backlinks, very steady, took a big growth here in 08, continued through 09, and then it really exploded last year. And then over here, you're gonna see a nice steady stream of referring domain names. Now this is individual domain names that are referring traffic and having a backlink to Pro Liability. Now this is interesting. I want to show something here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to 2-year view of this same index. And what I want to show here is if you look at the referring domain name discovery over the last 2 years, it's gone from about 600 to about 1200, which is about double. However, the backlink discovery has gone from 5,000 to 20,000 with a big bulk of that coming in the last, I'd say, year or so. What does that tell me? It tells me ProLiability is getting a lot of backlinks. However, they're not getting them from a wide and diverse set of domain names. So this could be a problem for unnatural looking link profiles and that kind of thing, which I'm going to talk about in just 1 second. So what I wanted to look at really quick now was the anchor text that's being used to link to the Pro Liability website. And what I found was out of the top 1,000 referring anchor texts, I found that the majority of them said liability insurance and then Marsh liability insurance, the bulk of them. So if Pro Liability wants to go after the term liability insurance, they're going to need to step up their game in terms of getting backlinks and getting a more natural profile. Because what's happening is, I believe, the reason that they're not ranking as high and work they need to do is because their backlink profile does not look natural. All their anchor text has keywords in it. If you look, everything says liability insurance, Marsh liability insurance, or some variation thereof. There's no click here. There's no click for more information. There's no just with their domain name. They just have 30 backlinks, which is proliability.com, 30 out of 1,000. That does not look natural. So I want to warn Pro Liability with regards to over SEOing their offsite link building and their on-page link building, which we already talked about. Now I want to talk about maybe some paid links that Pro Liability has. I don't want to get them in trouble, but I want to address it because it's very important. Let's take a look at that right now. One of the websites that I found a backlink to ProLiability from was from this site here, Middle Tennessee State University, in a section that they call Recreation and Leisure Services. And as you see here, ProLiability is at the bottom under Recreational Therapy Links, stuck with American Therapeutic Recreation Association, National Recreation and Parks Association, and here's Liability Insurance. I don't know. That's a little gray to me. Looks a little bit paid. Pro Liability should be very aware of what's going on there and make sure they're not paying for links. Let me show you another example. This example, this is from a website called MoneyCake. Now, Pro Liability is getting tons of links from MoneyCake, and I wonder why. Why are they getting so many links from MoneyCake? Well, I found it. The reason is they're getting a link from MoneyCake because they're on their blog roll for Marsh Liability Insurance, which is a direct link to proliability.com. Now, I don't know about you, but a blog roll means you link to other people's blogs that are about those topics. And if you look, there's payday loans and all kinds of other things in here. This looks iffy to me, guys. This looks like a paid link. I just want to warn you about this. I'm not trying to call you out or get you in trouble, but Google frowns upon this kind of stuff. So this is another example of what I think may be a paid link. I could be wrong, but I'm just pointing it out. Let me show you one more quick example. In this final example, this is from the Orange County Bar Association. And this is seems to be a sponsors section right over here that has Marsh Insurance, a link to Marsh, which goes to proliability.com. So this, out of all the paid links or the potential paid links that I've just shown, is probably the most legitimate one because you're on a sponsored section here. So this is more, maybe more acceptable and more legit than some of the other ones because it's a known sponsored section. But again, this looks like a paid link. And if this is part of the link building strategy that you guys used in the last half of last year that showed that big explosion of links that I just showed in the other screenshot, be very careful. This could backfire on you and prevent you from ranking high, especially with Google Panda just being released. So I just wanted to go over some other quick little kind of house cleaning, housekeeping details for your Pro Liability to cover. Of course, this breakdown, this audit that I'm doing is not comprehensive. I don't have the time in a short little video like this to show everything that's wrong with their website and what to do, but I'm trying to hit some big points that they need to address. So let's finish off with some quick housekeeping things that I think they should take care of. And what I noticed is when I look, aside from the site being overly SEO optimized, which we've covered already, needs to tone that down, it needs to be more real and all that good stuff. But aside from that, I looked at the code on the back end, just did a quick view of it, and I found a couple different things. First of all, there's this flash pack navigation system. And I noticed that on the Marsh, or excuse me, on the Pro Liability page, when you have your drop-down menu, this is flash. Now I want to warn you guys, or JavaScript, excuse me, Java. I want to make sure that search engines can crawl this because sometimes they have difficulty crawling these navigation elements if they're not done in the right way. Have your team, your programming team, make sure that this can be crawled and indexed by Google. I think it is. I think it's working fine, but I want you guys to make sure of that. That's the first thing I noticed. Next thing I noticed was there's no canonicalization of your pages. So you need to have the tag that says rel equal canonical on all your pages so that if there's ever duplicate content, Google knows which page is the right page. It also serves you for your home page so that if you have a home page, for instance, that has a trailing slash or just says .com or .com slash or without the www, if it just says Pro Liability without the www like that, it'll go to the right page and it won't be seen as duplicate content by Google and other search engines. So I also wanted to talk just briefly about your title tags. I know on a lot of your pages, they're very bland. And you may want to think about including some professional branding in your title tags. So professional liability insurance, malpractice insurance, and maybe you stick up here something, you know, where it says proliability.com, you know, like that. And have the little pipe or hyphen there at the top, just to kind of brand your page, just to make it more search engine friendly and more people friendly so it looks like a company rather than just having cold keywords with nothing else. Same thing for your descriptions. The description tags look okay. And then I noticed keywords. You guys actually use keywords? I mean, seriously? Come on now. I noticed that you don't just use like a couple keywords, but like 100 different keywords. Look at this. Whee! This is ridiculous. You, while keywords may not help your ranking anymore, search engines don't use them anymore for ranking, they can hurt your ranking. In fact, Bing just came out recently and said that they look at the keywords tag, but to look for spam and spammy websites. So you're telling Bing, hey, come look at my spammy website and penalize me because I got all these keywords. Get rid of your keywords on all your pages as part of just this housekeeping kind of cleansing process. And last but not least is page rank leakage. If you have way too many categories coming from your homepage to other pages, you will lose page rank, and each one of those pages will rank less and less in Google because you're passing it on your initial site's page rank value to too many different pages. So you may want to think about consolidating some categories or doing something else to help the navigation so you don't lose that SEO value. Okay, so that is some quick and dirty SEO top level stuff. Let's look at page level SEO stuff. So now we're moving on to page level SEO stuff. And while most of this was already covered because my basic consensus on the website itself, as well as the overall top-down SEO, applies to the page level, there's a few page-specific things that I want to go over. First of all, in keeping with that same premise, I want to talk about making these pages warmer, more friendly, having better content, and having a reason, giving people a reason to link back to them and share them with folks. So things like having a video, having a video explanation of what this liability is, insurance is for athletic trainers or personal trainers, how it can help their career to protect them from catastrophic lawsuit, for their business, something like that where it resonates with them on an emotional level. That's something very important to do. Then each of these pages should have maybe reviews, maybe comments. How about social sharing? And I'm not just talking about these generic ones that your programmers just threw down there real quick. I'm talking about real sharing. I'm talking about some good individual page level sharing and commenting to make this warmer and better. So that's page level stuff on the surface. Now let's look at maybe some quick SEO stuff as well. So looking at the title tag of these pages, these look pretty good. Your description tag looks fine. Maybe a little generic because you're using the same description tag with just changing the keyword for athletic trainers. And then instead of athletic trainers, you'll put dentists or something else. So that's a little bit generic. So you may want to think about maybe sprucing those up a bit. Again, you have a keyword here. And heck, if you're going to go for the keywords, don't include the hyphen. You might as well get rid of the hyphen, say athletic trainers, and add the other ones. But get rid of this altogether because it doesn't belong there anyway. The other stuff is fine. You're doing some alt text for your images and things like that. So that part of stuff is good to go. I just want to reiterate the changes that I talked about before for making the page not just SEO friendly, but user friendly. That's the key to everything. Couple points on the on-page stuff. If you notice here, when I mouse over this image, it links back to this page. So if I click on that, it comes right back to this page. Remove those links. Links in the headers do not help your rankings. In fact, they can hurt your rankings because it's a virtual cycle loop, which is another reason why you need the rel canonical tag on your pages. Finally, there's no outbound links on any of your pages to content on other websites, like-minded websites, maybe that aren't competitors, but something like a Wikipedia or some other website that has good content that you can reference to give people more help in figuring out what liability insurance means to them, how it can help them, what happens, how does it work, giving them some outside resources. Google loves when you link to like-minded websites and authoritative sources of information to help people figure out what your website is about, as well as to just be a useful resource to people that come to your site. So make those changes, improve number one above anything, get this content fixed, make it more interactive, refresh your site, make it warm and inviting, and get some content that people really care about. And you're gonna start to see things really zoom in terms of your return on investment. Now, let's finish this off with three actionable strategies that you need to implement immediately to improve your bottom line results, your traffic, your sales, your leads, and ultimately your cash flow. So now I want to give you a three-step website and SEO action plan for ProLiability.com. First, ProLiability needs to redesign the site for user friendliness, warmth, their unique selling proposition, and not just a cold, stale landing page for insurance. ProLiability.com wants to be the number one provider of liability insurance. Well, there's two ways to do that. You can have the cheapest prices or the best, most user-friendly experience and customer service. They need to tweak their website for either value proposition, but pick one and run with it. Second, they need to execute a complete content, social media, and inbound marketing strategy immediately. They'll do that by taking a ground-up approach and getting to know their end customer, who they are, what do they want, and how can ProLiability.com help them? ProLiability then needs to include a blog and make the content engaging, entertaining, timely, but most of all, shareable. Then, the company needs to direct a complete social media strategy immediately and start talking to their customers and potential customers. Third, the website, meta tags, the content, the navigation, URLs are too optimized. That worries me a little bit. ProLiability might get penalized with Google's upcoming changes to their search algorithm. They should be very careful. Also, if they are, they should stop paying for links immediately. And if they aren't, then construct a more natural backlink profile with links that don't contain any keywords at all, mixed with partial and full match anchor text links to different pages on their website, which they're not doing right now. Then, with their content, start utilizing inbound marketing and legitimate link outreach to improve their overall SEO profile. The bottom line, ProLiability.com has the potential to be a much larger player in the professional liability insurance game. With more attention to creating something of value and engaging their end user with a more friendly and easier to use website, they'll start to see not only their traffic and rankings improve, but more importantly for the company, their leads and sales increase as well. This is Chris Fernandez, and I really hope you enjoyed this webinar and got a lot of value from it. To gain access to even more great content like this that will help you systematically fix what's wrong with your internet marketing strategy and gain a critical leg up on your competition, I invite you to read the latest blog post on the Bikwitus blog and follow us through whatever social media channel you prefer, or receive updates sent directly to your inbox. Thanks so much.